Once again, a very warm welcome to all of you here at the PITS CMO Summit 2018, which is powered by Colors and ABP News. I would request you all to kindly please put your mobile phones on silent mode, but do not turn them off, because we have a very interesting Twitter contest for all of you, and you all can win lots of exciting prizes throughout the sessions. All you have to do is use hashtag PitchCMO, and the most creative tweets are going to win exciting prizes during the sessions, as I just told you all. Ladies and gentlemen, PitchCMO Summit brings together top marketers of the country on a single platform to discuss and share insights about the ever-evolving field of marketing. The agenda of the summit each year revolves around marketing in the present context and focus on the best ways to market to Indian consumers in a dynamic environment. The theme for today's PitchCMO Summit is generating brand love. Are you really listening to your consumers? A marketer's job is of mixed intuition and of listening to his consumers. Big data and innovative digital technologies have made the science of listening more efficient. At the 2018 Delhi PitchCMO Summit, the best minds in the business will talk about the art and science of effective listening. A brief note on our organizers. The Exchange for Media Group was set up in the year 2000 with the aim of publishing niche, relevant, and quality publications for marketing, advertising, and media professionals. Today, Exchange for Media is a one-stop information platform for the entire industry news, views, analytical information, in-depth analysis of events, and trend forecasting. Exchange for Media publications have a credible and loyal following. Presently, the group has five titles in its portfolio, namely exchangeformedia.com, Pitch, Impact, Reality Plus, and samacharformedia.com. Before we commence, we would like to acknowledge our partners without whom this event would not have been possible. The 11th edition of PitchCMO Summit is co-powered by Colors and ABP News, Aapko Rakhe Aage. Associate partners, National Geographic, 9X Jalwa, your channel for forever hits. Our co-partners are BTVI, Business Television India, India's premier English news channel, TVF. Our co-partner and badge partner are Dainik Savera Times, Andhere Se Ujale Ki Or. Knowledge partner, Lakshya Media Group, one of the largest independent marketing and communications network. Our luxury partner, Da Milano. Live webcast partner, 24 digital frames. Video technology partner, Videogram. Ladies and gentlemen, let's take a look at our partner's AV.
Thirkenge India ke qadam, dekhenge kis generation mein hai dam. Dance Diwane ke Mumbai auditions ho rahe hain 5 Mai ko Ryan International School mein. Registration ke liye apna dance video bheje niche diye gaye email address par ya upload kare Voot app par. Dance Diwane, 2 June se Shanivar Ravivar raat 9 baje.
इस तेजी से बदलती दुनिया में हर सही चीज पर पकड़ होनी चाहिए। जिंदगी में घुलते जहर पर पकड़, नोटों के बदलते रंग पर पकड़, किसी की रोजी रोटी की फिकर पर पकड़, प्लास्टिक में बदलते कागज पर पकड़, मैच के बदलते रुख पर पकड़, हर उठती आवाज पर पकड़। एबीपी न्यूज रखता है हर खबर पर पकड़, ताकि आप रहें सबसे आगे। एबीपी न्यूज आपको रखे आगे।
We believe in a solution of a special kind, one that can do a lot more than just solve your problem, one that can be a ray of hope in moments of darkness, one that brings life to a still business, one that helps overcome a hurdle, one that gives an opportunity to innovate. At Spotlight, Our handpicked team of content creators and problem solvers specialize in providing such solutions. That's why our solutions designed across different mediums and networks are customized, focused, and effective. From creating unique branded properties to in-show brand integrations, we ensure that our solutions are effective and result-oriented. And that's how we help you bring the focus back to your brand. Spotlight.
Team Lakshya worked very closely with me in deciding how to take the brand of Republic and embed it in the consciousness of people even before the launch of the channel.
So we are committed to working with Lakshya for the long term because that is how we believe this collaboration will yield very rich dividends for us.
See, for us, Lakshya has never been just an agency. For us, they have been more like a consultant. So we have given them the objective, what we're trying to achieve, and they've always come back with a plan to achieve that objective.
The first name in outdoor that comes to, you know, my mind or my team's mind is certainly Lakshya, because there's a credibility behind it.
There is something about this organization that has not just helped my brand grow, but which has had an infectious feeling among our marketing teams, our brand teams, our business teams, and many people in our editorial team. And I'm deeply grateful to Lakshya and help us become the number one media brand. As we grow in digital, we are going to lean once again on them. And in every step of our journey, we'll work with Lakshya. Thank you so much.
Ladies and gentlemen, for 130 years, National Geographic has told stories that have led people to care for the planet. National Geographic and Farhan Akhtar are looking for stories that will help us build a better tomorrow. You can send your ideas on www.lightscameraearth.com and you could get a chance to have your story produced by National Geographic. Additionally, two shortlisted stories will get published in the National Geographic's India magazine. This time, let's put the spotlight on Earth. Ladies and gentlemen, let's take a look at this AV.
Okay. So, what will your film be about? About something that will make you popular?
Got it.
Or the everyday things that just never change? About how we may be at war with our own selves? Or will your film go further? About how you stood your ground against all odds, took matters into your own hands, and inspired millions to stand with you. Because that's the film we want to see.
If you have an idea that can build a better tomorrow, then send it to us on lightscameraearth.com and you could get a chance to have it produced by National Geographic.
This time, let's put the spotlight back on Earth.
Ladies and gentlemen, before we begin this evening, a quick reminder to all of you to win exciting prizes. All you have to do is tweet using hashtag PitchCMO, the most innovative tweet, is going to win exciting prizes throughout this event. Ladies and gentlemen, to begin this evening, may I call upon an entrepreneur, journalist, internet evangelist, and media expert, all rolled up into one. I request Mr. Annurag Batra, Chairman, Editor-in-Chief of Exchange for Media Group and PW Group, to kindly please come and join me on stage. A very warm welcome to you.
Thank you, Tejal. Good afternoon. It's my honor and privilege to be here. We started Pitch on 15th October 2003. This year will be 15 years of Pitch. We are happy that we are again bringing back the Pitch events to cities beyond Delhi, Bombay. We are taking the Pitch CMO Summit to Bangalore. I'd like to especially welcome some special guests who are here, some who've come from other parts of India and some who've come from outside India. So let me first do that formal duty and then I'll come to the topic. First, I'd like to welcome Mr. Tim Castry, right? He's just gone out, so he can, at least it's, in India, it's a customary to acknowledge your guest. He's our keynote speaker. He's the global CEO of WaveMaker. So I welcome Mr. Tim Castry. It was my special pleasure to briefly meet Mr. Vijay Mansukhani, who's the MD of Onida. When I saw him, I told him that when I grow up, I want to be like you. It means reinventing yourself. That's what I meant. You as a brand, as an enterprise, are reinventing yourself. Welcome, Mr. Castry. We acknowledge your being here while you weren't here. Also, my friend Sudeep, who's now become the CEO of VIP Industries. So he's a CMO who's become a CEO. I keep saying that, you know, CMOs are ideally suited to become CEOs. Would also like to welcome all other speakers, Mr. Anshuman Goenka, Ms. Naseeb Puri, Mr. Sanjay Bhutani, Shilpa, my friend Ajay Kakkar, my friend Amit Tiwari, Kapil Pillai, Shankar Nath, Vivek Srivastava. So I'm just doing, it's a basic duty to recognize people who are speaking here. I also like, Sai, I was happy to see you. Alokji, thank you for being in part of whatever we do. You know, today the topic is, are you really listening to your consumers? I can tell you that they say, some philosopher said that we don't listen to hear. We listen to pass judgments. This is what an astrologer said. Also, one of the most sincere forms of respect is actually listening to what another person has to say. I am in the next 21 days completing 18 years of marriage. And I can tell you, listening is a challenge. I say it jokingly. As a boss also, I could accomplish more. As an entrepreneur, as a colleague, as a co-worker, I could accomplish more if I listened more. And I say it absolutely on a serious note. Most often in our personal lives, we tend to overestimate our own understanding of an issue. I'm talking about myself, so if all of you get it 100% right all the time, then of course you're geniuses, and I'm sure there are many in the room. But I can tell you that whenever I have listened to someone with an open mind, and I'm not fond of Navjot Singh Sidhu, but he said something many years on a TV show which stuck in my mind. Not that I have won, I've been married for 18 years. My mind is confiscated. But Navjot Singh Sidhu said, a mind is like a parachute. It only works when it's open. So an open mind, because as business leaders, as marketeers, as people who created brands and are nurturing brands, we tend to have sometimes right, sometimes not so right, ideas of what works for the brand, what the consumer wants. And we tend to sometimes ignore ground realities. I'm not saying all of you do. You wouldn't be here in this room if you were not doing very successful. But the world is changing. There is a new normal. We've just brought out the 36th anniversary issue of Businessworld, and we've tried to look at various parts of a consumer's life. We've looked at industries, and we've tried to see what will happen 10 years from now. And the beauty is that we don't even know that there are things that we don't know. I'm becoming philosophical, sir. This is what happens as your numbers of years of marriage go up. So I'm not going to talk to you about marketing, but I can only tell you about myself, that whenever I have listened more, whether to a colleague, whether to a brand leader, whether to a salesman, whether to somebody who's come to discuss something with me, I have walked out with very clear answers. If not clear answers, I've had the right questions. The job of a marketer or a leader is to ask the right questions and then listen. I think if I can master that, I can be a better brand leader. I look forward to learning from all of you about how you do the process of listening, how you funnel the insights, and then how you finally use it in your businesses to build brands that outlive the categories that they serve. Because brands and products are continuously reinventing themselves and are becoming relevant to consumers in more ways than one. I won't talk about brands that were relevant, say, 10 years from now, 5 years from now, but are no longer relevant because they stopped listening to consumers. They did not reinvent themselves. And I wanted to, because this is a forum about media, advertising, communication, but more importantly, brands. I am a first generation entrepreneur. I acquired Businessworld 4 years back, and I've tried to do something with it. We are still maybe 3 months far off from where it should be. But I was making a list of people I should meet to understand the business of building businesses and the business of building brands better. And I thought of a person who I personally admire. I haven't had the pleasure of meeting him multiple times, Uday Shankar. And I want to talk about this person because, you know, Uday, in a conversation, would listen more. I met him 15 years back when he used to be at India Today Group. My friend Rajesh Shishadri introduced me to him. And look at where he's come. He's reinvented himself. He was a news guy who then set up a news channel as a CEO. He was a journalist. Then he became the CEO of a entertainment group. And today, look, in the last 10 years, where has Uday taken it? And, you know, I wanted to talk to you about Uday because in some way he's reinvented himself. And, you know, he's a very good listener. I can talk to you about another listener that I've had the good pleasure of interacting more than 200 times with no paucity of time from his side, a gentleman called Dr. Subhash Chandra. I can tell you if I spent 50 minutes with him, which is the average I've spent with him most of the times I've met, he would listen for 35, 40 minutes. And, you know, he keeps... I'm just talking about these personal conversations because at the end of the day, we don't do listening. And that extends in our spheres of work. We rely on research agencies who may themselves use outdated techniques and preconceived notions of what consumers are doing, because you cannot straitjacket consumers. Today, consumers have multiple personalities. We all have multiple aspirations and personalities, bucket lists. So the reason I'm talking about this is listening should lead to reinvention. Listening should lead to creating new ideas and new brand personalities. I want to tell you that recently a university recognized that I have permanent head damage and on Sunday gave me a doctorate. So I'm Dr. Annurag Batra, right? And I was talking about, I'm not very happy about it because I cannot help you grow hair, Alokji, nor can I help myself. I'm not that kind of a doctor. But my joke to Arnab, and they were telling an editorial colleague of mine, Arnab and Vikas, that, you know, tell Annurag that we haven't done more than one email. I've got this for emailing. Some people who work with me know how many emails I send at what points of time in the day or night. But the reason I'm bringing this up is that when I got the PhD on Sunday, I was thinking of reinventing myself in terms of learning new things and unlearning. I think the biggest challenge is that we stick on to some of the things that have worked for us in the past, and they may certainly work for us in the future. But I have realized that there is a new normal, and some of the things that worked in the past may not work in the future. So I don't want to go on telling you about brands. I can tell you that we built the brand Exchange for Media purely because of our deep involvement with the community and the passion we have for the business of media advertising communication. We got lucky along the way. On 30th May, we are also celebrating the Hindi Patrakarita Devas. Most people don't know that we have a site on Hindi, like Exchange for Media, called Samachar for Media, which is equally popular, more popular than Exchange for Media. I can tell you, Abhishek is our editorial lead on that. And, you know, often editors, including very powerful editors, call me and complain about his stories. That tells you that it's being read. So we celebrate the business of Hindi journalism on the 30th of May. And our keynote speaker there is the Nobel laureate, Shri Kailash Satyarthi. We'll formally announce it next week. Also, Naval told me to talk about our biggest initiative, and it's in a domain where brands are being built or being annihilated. We have the Tech Munch, our digital conference, and our IDMA, which is in the 8th year, on 27 June at the Taj Santa Cruz in Mumbai. The jury chair for the IDMA is Mr. Sanjeev Mehta, who has a fantastic kitty of brands, and he's leading the company fantastically to be able to build on whatever he has. I don't want to spend more time talking about our initiatives, but I want to use this opportunity to express my gratitude to all our speakers who come from various parts of the country and some from outside the country to give you nuggets of their wisdom and their ideas about what the future is going to be for brands. Thank you. God bless you.